Hi everyone, Ian Van Tuyl here, and behind me is a brand new 2023 Bavaria C50 that just showed up here in San Diego, California. This particular vessel I have sold and we're in the commissioning process right now, but I wanted to give you a brief tour about what everything that we're going to be doing to this vessel and just kind of show you a little bit behind the scenes. So here we go.
Here we are looking at the Bavaria C50. This is the profile from standing out the dock, and as you can see, it is absolutely gorgeous. We just completed the custom canvas done by Memo's Custom Canvas here in San Diego, California. He's also done custom cockpit cushions, but this will give you a nice quick preview of this yacht. Sitting right next to it is the Bavaria C57 that we just sold and delivered, but as you can see, the yachts are very similar in size, even given the length, but you can really tell the difference from down below. The C57 has a straight inboard garage for the dinghy, and the C50 has it a thwartward ship. So you do pull it up here and you turn it sideways. So as we come aboard the vessel here, you're gonna see this amazing large swim platform. This is operated with a push button right here underneath this latch seat here. You can see just how large it is. I mean, it is really impressive about the size. Also, underneath, you can see that really nice stainless steel reinforcement down there, these large hinges here with built-in gas shocks, a nice step ladder getting you on board the vessel. There is also a turbo max compressor. This is an air compressor to inflate, deflate the dinghy. And again, just looking at the quality of the pulley systems that pull it up. We have a swim step shower here, hot and cold. I guess before I go too far, I better show you this other cool trick features here at the back of the boat. This lifts up and you have a really nice stainless steel faucet here. This is a just kind of an open area for cutting or just drainage as well too, if you want to put some ice back there. And then we have our little grill here in the back. So really nice design here, really utilizing the space. What I'm going to show you here in a second is just in forward of this is a built-in refrigerator. So hot and cold swim step shower, opening a door here allows us access to the port side of the helm where we have the Fusion stereo system, the BNG autopilot controllers, the large BNG glass mat displays, and then we also have two electric winches. So we have the outboard electric winches and the inboards. These are the custom covers that we had made. And we also have a BNG multi-repeater display. Notice all of the sheets and halyards are leading aft to the helmsman here. There are no cabin top winches, so it really utilizes everything, bringing it back here for the helmsman to really operate. There's our Dometic built-in refrigerator. Pretty cute. This opens up, gives you a nice accessibility right there to refrigeration here in the cockpit. Below here, this opens up and gives us access down into the dinghy, a storage garage. And then we also have these really trick platforms that lift up into place. So when you're heeled over, you actually have that angle footing that you so desire. But otherwise, they close off, and it's really a nice setup here. All right, so at the helm, again, similar to the port side, we have the two electric single-speed Lumar winches here. Our compass, our Yanmar engine display here. So when sitting here at the helm, this is a nice profile here. You have great visibility, and obviously if the cover's off the Dodger, phenomenal visibility. BNG display, second autopilot controller, and then this is pretty cool here. I got to show you this. This is the side power controller. This is a variable speed. Now we have stern and bow thrusters, so you really can utilize, you know, the maximum of the power to make the boat go sideways, pivot it in a circle. This really is a nice setup for single-handed use, especially if you're in a position where you just, you know, need to make the boat go sideways. Well, there you have it, getting the option for the stern thruster. Before I go too far in the cockpit, I want to show you just how easy it is to walk up right onto the side decks here. Maneuverability is quite nice. Stainless steel grab handles, huge wide side decks, lots of flat platform here. All the sheets, halyards leading into the cockpit. And again, you look at the finish work that's done. Look at that braided line going right down to these waterproof fittings. I mean, that is really nice, you know, craftsmanship there on the commissioning side. So this has a self-tacking head sail on it. But again, you have so much deck lounge area up here. It's really, really impressive. This opens up, and this will gain us access right down into this huge sail locker. So as you can see here, we have steps going right down to a sail locker, and then up there, that full glassed in bulkhead, that is the anchor locker just forward of that. Our windlass drops down into the anchor locker, all the chain, and then now it leads us into our bowsprit. Bowsprit set up with two attachment points, one for asymmetrical, second for code zero. We have the Furlex furler here for our head sail. And then again, let's look at these beautiful clean lines that the Bavaria C50 has to offer. This is a double spreader Selden mast with radar up at the top. That's a B&G radar, wind point, wind speed. There's also a deck light. And then we've also brought in really cool spreader lights as well too, as a factory option. All right, great design here for the Dodger. We sat down with Memo and we designed it for the height of the owner. And again, we did a single cover here. So this obviously opens right up. We have the really nice macrolon glass. So that's really, quite nice to look through. It looks like you're looking through a windshield. And then again, we use this really nice light kind of gray material to match the boot stripe and then the cove stripe. All right, as I mentioned, great, easy access. Now we're gonna move into the cockpit. The cockpit looks kind of funny here because we have the tables removed. We're spraying those with high gloss, but we have large lazarette lockers here to both starboard and port side here. And then again, you have your dinghy garage in the back. And then these tables are on these electric lifts, which are a switch button here. So this will actually lower and raise, so you can turn them into additional lounges or have them set up as tables, or one as a lounge and one as a table, whatever you desire. But yeah, really nice trick electric base there. The companionway hatch slides down right into this area here. This has an opening so you can clean out the scuppers and what have you. But really nice accessibility there. And then you also have these really cool looking ports in each cabin and overhead opening hatches as well. All right, as we come down below, it's a really nice gradual steps here down into the vessel. We have the galley off to the port side. The galley on the C50 is really impressive because we have a dedicated freezer, a refrigerator. There's a trash bin. This is a huge trash bin, located right here. Beautiful countertops here. They have this really nice, kind of edge groove to them as well too, so it acts as a handle and then also for stuff sliding off. We have a large stainless steel sink off to the starboard side. Port side has a smaller stainless steel sink, and then we also have a refrigerator icebox here. So nice use of space. Three burner electric stove and oven. Really nice drawers. Also, look at the dovetail joints here on the woodwork. Craftsmanship is really impressive here on the Bavaria yachts. We added a 110 outlet here. We have the microwave. There's an overhead vent that will vent everything that's being cooked here at the stovetop. Also, an overhead opening hatch too. I mean, huge ceilings. I think this is like 7-foot ceilings throughout the vessel. So it's really impressive, and it's also one level. Here we have one of the aft cabins. This is the VIP cabin. We have a head and shower located behind this door, and then a really nice queen size berth here with accessibility that allows you to kind of walk up and get into bed. But I open this up just to kind of show you. This is the stern thruster to the vessel. So this is really cool how this is designed. There's actually a trap door that will drop down and then expose the thruster itself and then bring itself back up when not in use. So it creates a minimum drag. We have the dedicated batteries for that. But again, you look inside, you see the fit, the finish, the electrical. It is quite impressive. And also what I really like is just all the behind the scenes things, because if you look at this, this is all engineered. So it unlocks and then lifts out. But otherwise, when it's locked into place, it's sturdy. And so it's not going to vibrate, just a normal panel just sitting here. So it does lock into place, which is, quite nice. Nice cabinetry built here, additional storage. This gains us access aft into all of our steering quadrants and what have you. really nice large porthole here, and then again opening hatches, you know. And even in here, I just want again to point this out, you look inside, everything's finished out. So it's, again, it's these small little details that you see here, you know, really nice shades that drop down, you know, taking a look at all the other models. Look at the little stainless steel, you know, kind of kick guards here on the edges. It's just to kind of help protect that, you know, so you don't chip the wood and what have you. So here in the VIP head compartment, I'm gonna turn on a light switch here. We have the shower wand. We have the sink fixture here. Nice angled, you know, vanity. This is quite nice. And then we also have the electric quiet flush toilet. As again, as I mentioned, it is in the commissioning process. So we still have cardboard and a lot of things. We're actually going to be installing a couple other large units here shortly. But going off to the starboard side, this is access to the day head, if so desired. But you have three cabins, three heads. So in this cabin, you know, we've stowed all of the cushions for the cockpit. We still have the bed here. And then we're gaining access here to install a generator. But this is the Yanmar here inside the engine room. Really nice and accessible. And again, everything's really clean. Very, very accessible on all of the components, which I really love. You do have a hanging locker, air conditioning controls. Again, really nice cabinetry around that. Look, I mean, these doors are impressive. Really nice doors. What I love is they put this rubber seal on them. So when you close them, you won't have rattling here. Plus, they're solid. You know, they're really thick doors, great hinges. I love the teak grates in the head compartments. This is the Japsco quiet flush toilet, the sink, the vanity, and then you have your own walk-in head compartment here, which is quite nice. So this, you know, encloses off here, and it gives you a nice, you know, shower, place to sit. There's also additional, you know, storage area for toiletries, towels, what have you. But when not in use, when this is opened up, and let's just say somebody's in this cabin and you just need a day head, well, this also acts as access to the day head. So you just kind of walk literally right through here and you have access to the day head. So pretty clever design. Really nice steps. I love about the steps is they're angled, and they also have these like rubber grips that are inlaid here. So they're routed out and this rubber inlay is there. So it makes it really nice and grippy. Plus it's not like you have a sandpaper or that grip tape to just kind of get, you know, clogged up with lint and what have you. So again, nice perspective of the aft cabins, this huge galley area. Now we're going to work our way into the salon. Before we get there, we have the nav station off to the starboard side. Again, really nice nav seat facing forward. Great cabinetry. I mean, the solid wood trim edges with the inlaid leather. Really impressive. We have the Fusion stereo, Dometic air conditioning controls, VHF down here. Obviously, you can integrate through Wi-Fi, all your navigation as well, too. Behind this panel is our interior, our systems, and our navigation. So this will allow us to monitor battery, tankage, everything that we need. Just forward of that is storage and just storage galore. Overhead, you have these really nice shades that pull down, that kind of enclose all of the hatches and then slide up out of place. Fabric type material here overhead, which is nice. And then these beautiful, you know, LED lights that are kind of hidden. So you can actually have the straight direct lights and or the hidden LEDs. All right, so now I'm working our way to the salon. Large bench off to starboard side here. Huge U-shaped seating here around this salon table. The salon table also is electric. There is a switch here. Whoops, I think there's a switch. Where did the switch go? Here. So this will actually lower and or raise the salon table. So it is pretty nice on, you know, the operation of that. So you can change its height, but turn it down and make it a bed as well too. You also have this huge bench seat here with additional storage built into that. And then as you can see, it's on a sliding system. So you loosen this up and then slide the whole bench under the table. And then you also have really nice drawers here, self-closing hinges. Beautiful leather. They've done a really nice job on all of their soft goods as well too, as well as all the cabinetry and everything that we see here in the salon. Starboard side salon, large bench seat storage underneath it, and then there is, you know, a button for the pop-up television that we are going to install. So this just lifts up, comes right out here, so you can get a really nice flat screen television in this location. And then behind this cabinetry, we also have additional storage, but great use of space, great design there. This lifts up, lots of storage below that. And as I mentioned earlier, just tons of storage everywhere we go. All right, so moving forward, cabinet here, additional storage, drawer space, lighting switches. We go into the master cabin. And this is pretty impressive, as you can see. We have access points on both starboard and port side of the bed. We have this beautiful inline queen berth, large headboard. Before I go too far, we look up. We have these ports here with shades. We have two opening ports there, side ports, and they've finished it out quite nicely. So off to the starboard side, we have the walk-in head compartment. So this has your sink, your head, cabinets for storage. Off to the opposite side is our full shower compartment. So shower accessibility here. So this is a dedicated shower. So they separate themselves from the head and shower. Here you have the same little opening vanity storage here for towels and, you know, all the goodies you need here for the shower. All right, coming back out of here, we were looking at lower storage compartments, upper storage compartments, huge hanging locker. I mean, storage on this boat is something that is not lacking in any way whatsoever. And they do a great job on all of the fit and finish throughout. Opening cabinets here, we have reading lights. Again, as I mentioned, the headboard. There's also 110 outlets, air conditioning controls. And then again, as we look just aft, you can see just how much room and real estate is here. And then this large mirror facing aft. All right, here we are coming back into the salon. So we'll give you a nice perspective of that. Well, I know it was a lot to cover in the short period of time. Stumbled through a couple things, but I hope you got the point. And I hope that you found this walkthrough to be helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to the Bavaria product, the C-Line series, this specifically is the C50 that we're on right now, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you, hopefully earning your business. And if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel for additional video walkthroughs like this. And hopefully together we're going to learn a lot of new things and definitely see what's new coming out in the market today. Thank you again.